with Charles Davis. As always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Evan McPherson has this one teed up, and off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. They'll begin the drive with a run by Dillon. And he'll get this just across the 25-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
On second down, here's the option. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 4 yards there on the keeper, but still going to bring up a third down.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself. And that may have been incomplete, but he reminds me so much of when my dad used to take me to the baseball stadium, watch the home run hitters in batting practice. I'll get to the stadium early just to watch this kid throw it. He can throw it out of the stadium.
And he is going to have the Steelers first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. Now Jackson. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pick up there of 20 yards. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. The keeper there turning into a big play of 23 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now Jackson on first down. Looking middle, and that's complete. And in for the Steelers touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Steelers will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he'll be out right at the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Opening carry of the game for Cordarrelle Patterson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Now you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
Half 85, half 85. 56, 56. Alert, alert, alert.
Allen now on first down. That's into a crowd and intercepted. picked off by the freak, Javon Kearse. And the Steelers are going to take possession of the football. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness, and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
On second down, Dillon. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. In search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. On third down, Jackson. This is caught. Touchdown. A.J. Dillon from 21 yards away. And the Steelers go up by 2 touchdowns. Well, forget about the weapons out wide. He knows he's got another weapon in the backfield in the passing game, Charles, and he utilized him perfectly on that play.
And the offense coordinator showed me something on that play, Brandon, because so often during a game, our cameras find them looking down at their play sheets, and you wonder if they're absorbing anything. He had something specific in mind, and he went to it, and it worked well.
Here's the Steelers' kick team as they'll boot this one away. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early, first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception. Given up the score, you're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now.
They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. They'll run with Patterson. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling. Play action. Now it's Allen. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. Boy, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on 1st and 10. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Lamar Jackson scampering home from 19 yards out. And the Steelers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. So, Charles, that's 3 touchdowns on 3 drives, and it's just been an offensive barrage so far.
Great word, partner, using barrage right there. I'm going to add another word if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. absolute dominance throughout this ball game and no signs of slowing down.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that makes the score 21 to zip. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
From the 29, Allen. Finding Sanders on the crossing route. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Throwing on first down is Allen. Flush to his right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Javon Curse. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. To try again after the sack. Allen. And going deep for Hill. And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And the Steelers are going to take possession of the football. A nightmare of a first half for him. That's now 3 interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I agree, because you don't get to be one of the best quarterbacks in the league without developing some major mental toughness. So I expect him to go to the locker room at halftime, hit the reset button, and come out a new guy in half number 2.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. And he's going to be forced out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 42 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just help receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A.J. Dillon with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Steelers are able to widen their lead here in this first half. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And a route is on here in this first half. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left. More than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. This time they stay on the ground. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. First down, Allen. Being chased out left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. He's got a man complete. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Here's Allen to throw it. Throw right side, going to be caught here by Waddle. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. McPherson's kick is good. And that drops a deficit from 28 to 25. Well, the good news, at least they won't take that goose egg into the locker room. Maybe a little something to build on.
Yeah, it hasn't been the greatest of first halves for them, has it? But at least now, as you mentioned, they put some points on the board. And it's been funny, in our experience watching games, sometimes something as little as a field goal can change the fortunes of a team, and they could come out in the world sharp in the second half.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. 1 second, all that remains. Final play of the half here, it's Jackson. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. So we've hit intermission, it's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Jaguars with work to do. They trail here as we are back underway on EA Sports. This will be fielded inside the five. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history, and that's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And, partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late, that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is down to 28-10. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You can say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
Tony Field, what a play by him. That's a loss of 17.
Well, if an offense is going to throw the ball in this part of the field, any pass rusher will tell you that's his favorite part. Gets a chance to get after the quarterback. It's almost like a reverse red zone. They can create points using their deep.
In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone, loose. And he is not going to get away. The rush was too strong, and this is going to wind up a safety.
Every team has plays in their book to try and buy some room when a safety's on the table. But a big variable is, how does each team deal with the pressure of executing in those situations? In this case, they didn't, and they gave up 2 points.
And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They're going
going to start to drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 104 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. Here's Allen on first and 10. He's going to loft one deep left side here. He's got a man complete. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a big play for the Jaguars. 54 yards. They'll give to the big man, Campbell. And he'll get about four there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try.
And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Cordarrelle Patterson, his second touchdown of the night. And the Jaguars are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. They'll try and throw for it. And he is in for the 2 points, and they're back within a score as the lead's cut to 8. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter, despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
And they run the option here on first and 10. And he's going to get this one down to the 45. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down. Now that's what he can do when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained. And in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. That's big Jordan Davis powering in to drop him. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played 3 quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. And the Jags have 5 in the secondary here on third down. To throw is Jackson. He sets to fire deep. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Cameron Bynum. There he goes, right side. And they will finally get to him, but a great return has set him up first and goal at the 5. First and goal, a touchdown and a 2-point conversion here are musts. On the handoff, here's Campbell. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Earl Campbell, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Jaguars have a chance to tie things up as they trail by 2 here in the 4th. Allen will try to throw for it. He's got it at the 2. And he will get into the end zone for 2. And this game now tied here in the 4th. So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. Very short kick taken right at the 20. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this 4th quarter to try to grab that lead back. And this is going to be intercepted. picked up by Denzel Ward. And the Jaguars are going to take possession of the football.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
First and 10, it's Patterson.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
118 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2.
On second down, a run with Patterson.
And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Here's Patterson again.
The tackle by Troy Polamalu.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky. That play only picked up 5 yards.
And he's taken down after a gain of 3 as they move it from the 22 to the 19. Now, what's the thinking here? Because a touchdown would be nice, but you've ensured yourself a chance at 3 in the lead, so how worried are you about the 6?
You're not very worried about if you're confident in your kicker. And if you got a kicker who can put it through the post, you feel really good about trying to bleed that clock down. In an ideal scenario, your kicker puts it through the post as the clock hits zeros.
This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game.
3rd down, here's Patterson.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Here's Allen. Got a man, it's Waddle complete.
Touchdown, Jaguars!
Jalen Waddle
from 19 yards away.
And the Jaguars have broken our tie and have taken a 4th quarter lead.
Important extra point up and through, and they will take a 7-point lead.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Very short kick taken right at the 20.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game.
Here's Jackson. Connecting with Hill.
A beautiful fake. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. That one goes for 8 yards.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding where they are in the field?
Now Jackson.
Steps away to his left. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10.
2nd and 10. Jackson.
That's out to Hill, right side complete.
And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
The Steelers signal for the 2nd of their timeouts as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock.
Throwing, Jackson.
Buying time to his left.
Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And the Steelers are going to have 1st and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 2. Jackson to throw. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the two-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
A line of scrimmage once again, the five, as they get ready for second and goal. Jackson. And this ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime.
Obviously, the excitement level here is almost a fever pitch. Down one is tempted to go for two. I say you go ahead and kick the extra point. You got the home crowd carried into overtime.
I'm with you. I do see some fans, though, holding up two fingers. Easy now.
Yeah, but they're not the ones who have to actually make that call, are they?
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
Allen down to a knee, and that should just about do it. That was an excellent come-from-behind victory, Charles, especially there in the fourth quarter. Both offense and defense were clicking. They're going to feel good about this one.
Boy, are they ever, because the deficit they faced certainly wasn't small. They obviously did not give up on that one, and in the end, how about that come-from-behind victory?